Welcome. I hope you enjoy the video. Glycogen synthase located in the chromosome 19 in the position 13.33. Glycogen synthase can be classified into general protein families. The first one, from mammals and yeast, uses UDP glucose as a sugar donor. The second one, from bacteria and plants, uses ADP glucose as a sugar donor. Glycogen synthase is directly regulated by protein kinase, such as glycogen synthase kinase 3, protein kinase A, and casein kinase 2, and also by protein phosphatase 1, which activates glycogen synthase via dephosphorylation. Protein kinase are enzymes that belong to a very extensive family of proteins that share a conserved catalytic core. In the N-terminal extremity of the catalytic domain, there is a glycine-rich stretch of residues. In the central part, there is a conserved aspartic acid. A protein kinase is a kinase enzyme that modifies other proteins by chemically adding phosphate groups to them. It consists of about 300 amino acid residues. Now, talking about the gene, glycogen synthase is an enzyme in glycogenesis, the conversion of glucose into glycogen. Glycogenin begins the synthesis of glycogen but only acts to form the beginning of the glucose chain. There are two different processes. The first one, glycogenesis, is the process in which glucose molecules are added to chains of glycogen for storage. This process is activated during rest periods in the liver, and also activated by insulin in response to high glucose level. The other process is glycogenolysis, is the breakdown of the molecule glycogen into glucose, a simple sugar that the body uses to produce energy. It takes place in muscle and liver cells, so glycogen synthase expresses muscle cells and also hepatocytes that are liver cells. The body's cells needs a steady supply of fuel in order to function the right way. This fuel is glucose, a simple sugar as I've said before. The muscles and organs need a certain level of glucose in the blood to work properly. So, when the body is missing an enzyme and isn't able to use glycogen the right way, it leads to a condition called glycogen storage disease, that is a rare condition that changes the way the body uses and stores glycogen, a form of sugar. It affects the liver, muscles, and other areas of the body. It's passed down from parents to children, is hereditary, and it's most often seen in babies or young children, but some forms of GSD may appear in adults. Several types of GSD can occur, but these four are the most common ones. And as you can see, each one affects to a different part of the body. If you have GSD, some of the symptoms you would have could be tiredness, very slow growth, obesity, kidney problems, breathing, and heart problems. Treatment will vary depending on what type of GSD you have, but usually you must follow a special diet and take certain medicines. Another disease could be diabetic hypoglycemia, that is low blood sugar. And here you have some of the symptoms you would have if you have this disease. I hope you liked the video. Bye!